for an adult audience. Loveline may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
Loveline with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Hey, everybody, it's Loveline. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. Leanne Tweeden is our guest tonight.
Hi.
Leanne is the host of 54321 on Fox Sport Net. Extreme whatever show. And Leanne is also best damn sports show, period. And Leanne was in here, seems 5 months ago, 6 months ago.
Somewhere about that.
And she was a delight. We had a good time with her.
I had a great time with you guys, actually. I was sad. Remember, it was over before that. I was like, it's already midnight.
Yeah.
I'm happy to be back, though.
Yeah, the show either goes very fast or very, very slow.
Painfully slow.
Yeah.
What's it going to be tonight?
I don't know.
You're going to be gearing into
That's
a slow mode. Yeah,
I like to relax.
Let's move it, right?
Well, why should we move it? Leanne was here last time. She said it went too fast. We got to slow it down a little for her.
Slow it down. Pay a little attention.
All right.
Leanne, I've been staring at Leanne on the cover of the last month's FHM magazine, which has been floating around our office. You know, these magazines, they don't go in. I mean, they stay. They sort of move from desk to desk, but no one ever picks them up and throws them out.
Right.
So I've been staring at Leanne from last month.
What do you think?
It's good. Solid. You went and visited the troops. Was that what we were talking about last
Well,
time?
I was going. I think, had I gone to Afghanistan yet?
I went
to Afghanistan for Thanksgiving, and that was my second tour, but I'm getting ready to go to Kuwait and Iraq next week.
Wow.
Next week?
Yeah.
Holy yes.
In fact, somebody contacted us after we talked to her about it. Remember? We were all talking. We were just kind of discussing doing something for USO.
Yeah.
As a result of discussing with you. Yeah.
Yes.
Who contacted us?
Probably from the USO.
Somebody got us, and then nothing ever happened.
Yeah. You know what? It was probably me, because I told them about you guys, and I probably gave the number to the studio here, and they called.
No.
And obviously, you blew them off. That's all right.
Yeah. Don't tell them about that. You're kidding?
You didn't want to go to Kuwait?
Well, listen, when we decide to bomb Hawaii, I'm going.
I was just in Hawaii last weekend.
All these places, we're such idiots with our wars. We only get into it with these asshole places, you know? I mean, places are dumps. And they're not only dumps, they're halfway across the globe. You give me somewhere in, like, a Western Europe, maybe Tahitian Island.
Yeah. A little Argentina, Brazil.
I'd go to Central America or South America, check that out, especially if you did it during, like, Carnival or something. You know, here's what I'd like our government to focus on. Focus on some of the major international holidays, and then let's go there. Like, I'm sure, you know, Spain's got, they got the run of the bulls over there. I wouldn't mind checking that out. Let's focus our wars during peak travel seasons, and let's have some nice destinations, and I'll go there and entertain the troops. They can watch me relax.
Greece, Italy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sure.
Everyone's got to go to, like, Beirut and Afghanistan. Please. Nothing to do there. Just stare at...
Lots of sand and heat.
Yeah. And then you got a bunch of horny guys. Yeah?
And horny girls.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Forgot about that. Drew's page are going off.
Man, that kind of made me nervous.
All right, so what do we? What do we? We're not plugging. We're just plugging 54321, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
FHM 100 Sexiest, which I think you should come to that party.
Is that tomorrow night?
Yes, it is.
Where is that?
I wonder if I should say where it's at.
They'll have security. They're not going to let people in if they don't.
Raleigh Studios.
All right.
Yeah,
that's good. And how many of the sexiest you think will make it there? You know what I'm saying?
Probably most of them if they're in L.A.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's a good time.
Yeah. It'll be fun.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're a nice heterosexual male, you'll enjoy it, I'm sure.
Except Adam's always had a thing about those lists.
Yeah.
Why?
Because there's no particular order to them in my mind.
Right,
I mean, there's oftentimes girls in the 80s and 90s that seem much hotter than the 20s and 30s or even the teens, you know?
That,
you know, Christina Aguilera or Britney Spears, I mean, they're okay. Like, I would have them in high school if I had a chance. But, I mean, they were like, if they were in my high school, if Christina Aguilera or Britney Spears was in my high school, it would have been like the 29th best-looking chick in the senior class.
Mm. Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
That makes them number two in the United States? Really? I went to North Hollywood High, for Christ's sake. You go to Valley College. You go. Just go walk through the campus of the junior college over here. You'll find five chicks hotter than that.
Well, last year it was Anna Kournikova that was number one. What do you think of that?
Anna Kournikova is pretty hot.
You think number one, though?
No, not number one, but she's definitely, you know, got a nice leg up on Christina or Brittany. Yeah. No doubt about that. But so anyway, the thing about the list is when you're looking, you know, when you're drooling over number 98 and then number three is not so hot, it kind of screws up the... it's like if you had a list of best basketball players of all time and Michael Jordan was number 98 and, you know, Norm Nixon was number one. And Norm Nixon's a fine ball player, but... He shouldn't be listed number one. You know what I'm saying?
What number should Leanne be?
Leanne, number one.
Oh, stop it.
That's right, baby doll. Less than number one. Number zero.
Ooh.
Well, I mean less than one. 0.5. Because I'd like you to edge out number one.
Who is number one?
That's Minka.
Please.
Number one.
Uno.
Asian big boob queen.
Oh, Lord.
Jenna?
Yeah.
What were you? What number were you? You were high. You were in the 90s or the 80s or... 50? Where the hell were you? You weren't in the top 50, were you?
What?
Not you. I'm asking Leanne.
Oh, where were you? I was 39.
39?
Yeah.
Oh, that's solid.
Yeah.
Respectable.
It's. I was surprised.
Let me tell you why 39 is a good number to be, somewhere in the 30s, because
it's not that flip.
You don't get the backlash,
yeah.
Because if you're in the teens and you're not super smoking, boiling hot, or there's some Brazilian bikini model who's in the 70s who's hotter than you are, people get mad at you.
Right.
In the 30s.
They blame me.
30s, good spot. Good. No one argues with it. Smart.
Who is
very
number
smart.
One?
Minka. Jenna?
Yeah, I'm here.
You're 23?
What is this thing?
23.
What's up?
Oh, my God.
Well, it's kind of a graphic.
Drew, do you ever get tired of horrible radio?
Here we go. Jenna.
What is this thing? Oh, my God. Is he grabs Leanne's cell phone into the mic without saying what it is?
Well, it's a camera.
All right, just stop it, Drew. Just stop it. What are you doing? Jenna?
Yeah.
You're 23?
23.
Drew, just start thinking things. Stop saying them.
All right. So, I really enjoy, you know, anal sex.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it's actually my favorite thing. I
good
enjoy
times.
It more than,
wow.
You know, regular sex. And lately it's been more painful than it normally is.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm a little bit worried. I've been, you know, when I first started the first, you know, couple of months that I did it, I could take it, you know, five times in a night, easy.
Sure, sure.
And now it's kind of like every time we even go in that direction, I kind of pull away and, you know, ow, ow, ow. So,
five, okay, hold on a second. Let's get back to the five times. Because, yeah, I mean, I remember, you know, high school days taking it 5-10 times in the ass.
You, yeah. You
yeah. It was a simpler
but that was,
time.
That was just football
time.
Season.
True.
But why five times?
I think so, actually, yeah.
How does five times work?
It's interesting. Well, you know, you can't go back and forth between the holes generally. So once you start in one place, you kind of keep it there.
Yeah.
So I haven't.
Five times though, he has five orgasms in an evening via anal sex with you.
Yeah. He can probably go longer than that too. I just end up
longer, meaning more orgasms.
Yeah.
Than five.
Yeah.
How old is he?
27.
27. So you guys have sex. He gives it to you in the can and has five orgasms, sort of minimal, or used to.
He can still have that many. I just can't take it, you know, into that place anymore. Well, that many times.
Really? Wow. Holy Christ. I couldn't even, if I had a rear view mirror with a telescope hooked up to it, I couldn't see that far in the past. You know what I'm saying? Mm. I couldn't do that.
What a first caller.
Yeah, right out of the blocks. All right,
I'm
so
sorry.
Really, it's five orgasms, and it's all anal sex.
Well, yeah.
Leanne gets a bogus factor. Leanne, the thing you have to know about bogus, though, is women don't make bogus calls. Now, listen to the bunch of guys.
They don't have that gene.
Bunch of guys behind them in the room giggling.
Yeah.
They got put up to it.
Giggly.
Now, she's embarrassed.
I really am embarrassed. I'm really sorry I'm the first caller now. I'm really embarrassed.
Okay, but the point is this is uncomfortable for you to do now.
Yeah, and I can still take it, but it has to, you know, I've got to be, it used to be, I didn't even have to be warmed up per se, you know,
right.
But now I really need to be real warmed up and comfortable before I can take it at all and start,
mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Did you damage something, do you think?
I don't think so.
You can.
But it's The pain is definitely different. When you, obviously, you guys probably haven't had anything in that orifice before, so you don't understand the difference in pain. But the muscle pain, like when you contract your muscle, is usually what hurts when you first have it put in.
Uh-huh.
But this pain is different. It's not the muscle. It's definitely a different pain. So I don't know if it could be an injury. But
all right. Well, listen, why don't you get yourself checked out?
Yeah, it could be.
Who should look at her? Like a porn star, a specialist?
Yeah, proctologist.
All right. Go to a proctologist.
You can get fissures and abscesses and the tears and all kinds of
just
good stuff.
Just for the sake of dignity, tell him four times in a night. All right?
Is that really bad for girls?
That could get you on that 100 hottest list, by the way, right there alone.
And Adam's 100 hottest.
It makes
That's
you worry
right.
about the guy, too. That he would have to be, like, manic. He'd have to be bipolar mania to be able to do this, pull this off, so to speak, so many times.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah, it's like, yeah, you've three cornholes, and it's like, baby? Yeah. Yeah, the three times I got you in the ass, didn't do it for me. I mean, that was a snack, but I need the main course.
I mean, do you guys, have you ever done it or five times in one night, just normal?
No.
Like, in a row?
No.
I either, no.
I mean, not even at 18.
No.
Exactly.
No, maybe, exactly. Maybe I may have done it to myself, you know, because I was a bad, bad boy when I was in high school and, you know, I was homesick or something. But no, that's crazy talk right there. Sophia?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Okay, this is
wait a minute.
Update from Sophia.
Oh, update from Sophia. Now, Sophia, we've been talking to through the last few nights. And Sophia, her grandfather was sexually abusing her, right? Yeah, and we gave her a phone number to call, and she called that phone number.
And you got a meeting with the social worker.
And today, you met with the social worker.
She came to my school today.
Okay.
And I spoke to her for a long, long time,
mm-hmm.
And I didn't go home. I'm in this place that's like a transitional home, she said it's called.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And I'm going to be here for a little bit because she says I'm not ready to go back to my mom and my grandpa.
Right.
And then I might go to foster care. I'm going to go to counseling with my mom if she lets.
Okay.
And I'm going to go to counseling alone.
Great.
Good.
Do you feel
good
better?
Good for you.
Do you feel better?
I feel better after I spoke to her because no one had ever been so nice to me.
Great. Remember how nervous you were last night? How you thought that nobody could be nice?
But she was so nice. And I'm still scared. I don't feel I deserve it, but even if I don't, I felt different talking to her.
Good.
Okay, great.
You know, that's the best thing you can do. Good for you. Be strong. You know, every day is going to get better.
Any peers around there? Any kids you're getting friendly with or anything?
Well, I just got here today, but tomorrow there's like, they have like groups of girls, and they all like, you can say, but you don't have to say what you've been through.
Great.
And she told me there are going to be other girls who had like same problems. And there's also, this place, it has like 40 women.
Ooh.
And some of them are like me, and some of them are like older women who husbands beat them.
Mm. Ooh.
It's for people who don't have like husbands or kids, though.
And where do you sleep?
I'm going to have to go to a room with like three other people tomorrow, but tonight I have my own room.
Oh, that's cool.
That's great. You sound much better.
There's been a lot of less and off going on in those places.
Adam,
true.
Please, Adam, please.
It's true.
Please.
It's true. Sophia?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Good.
Yeah.
See? You took the first step.
Yeah.
Now give us a call in a couple more weeks and let us know how it all unfolds.
I could say thank you to the lady because I really wanted to.
Well, tell her thank you for us. Okay?
Yeah.
We appreciate her helping.
Was she a huge black woman?
No, she's white.
Mm. Huge. Huge, though, right?
No.
She's always huge.
No, but she's...
I think those counselors eat the first three kids they see.
Oh, my God, no, she's
It's true.
Nice.
Skinny? Eating disorder. Okay, so, hey, she's a saint. And God bless you, Sophia. You did the right thing.
And she said, I want to say thank you to the lady here, because I wouldn't have called if it weren't for her, and I just really want to say thank you.
All right. Hey, how about some props over this way, too, Toots? We're busting our chops every night for you.
Thank you.
Oh, that's nice of you.
Oh, it was Ann? It was Ann that talked to her? So it was Ann that made her call. That's good.
Really? Good
but
work,
I
producer Ann.
Thank you. And I was so scared last night, and I would have killed myself. I think I hadn't spoken to you, although I was sad when you hung up on me. But
Oh, that was true. Listen, Sophia.
Yeah.
It's this is the turning point in your life.
Yeah, this is it.
It's the first day of the rest of your life.
I know.
And so is tomorrow. So
you know,
is
I'm proud
day, right?
that she actually made
that's
that
the,
phone call. You know,
part.
I listen to you guys all the time, and I hear you guys give out numbers and hotlines and call somebody and get help, and it's nice to know to hear somebody actually did it and has actually made a step forward.
She did it. They made a connection. They kept it going. They
told me she's out. She's in a place at least where she's not going to get abused.
Occasionally, amazingly, these days, the system works.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just there's too many people that need the system, but when people can get in, it can work for them.
Well, her grandfather had been molesting her for like 10 years or something. It was horrible. She was living with him. I mean, she was a basket case.
At least she's out
anyone
now.
Anyone would be, yeah.
This is it, yeah. You she's know. Out. Boom.
How old is she?
15.
Oof.
That's something.
All right, so Sophia, Mazel Tov, as your people would say. It's got to be a Jewish family. Right, Drew?
Well, as you point
only
out,
Jews are in the foster care.
As you
care.
Pointed out, it's not, they, only them in the foster care. And
they're the only ones that fire guns in the air on the 4th of July and New Year's. Strictly the Jews, especially in Los Angeles. All right, good. Call us and keep us updated. And I hope the grandfather just dies a horrible death.
I'm gonna send that kid to visit the grandpa that twists people's heads off.
The grandpa or the caller?
Yeah, the grandpa.
We have a grandpa?
No, we had the guy that, what was his name? That
like, he twists off the heads of the guys.
Kenneth.
Why are guys named Kenneth extra creepy? Kens are fine. Kenneth, serial killer. What is that? You think the eth part would just make him gay, but it doesn't. It turns him into killers.
Regal something.
Yeah. Roger?
Is me.
All right.
Sorry. Hi.
I don't know. Roger, your response reminded me of something. I took a IQ test tonight on my computer.
Yeah. Oh, I hate this.
Yeah, it was the first time I've ever taken an IQ test, my knowledge.
How'd you do?
My wife came home from work, and she said she took an IQ test on a computer today at work.
She just stumbled on it, or
I don't know. You know, stuff moves around.
Yeah,
the
people
office.
Always
people find
and people
stuff
email
and they,
you.
Hey, do this.
Well, I bring it up because I'm doing some weird show, some show for Fox on Monday, a live show, IQ test for America.
Really? I've never taken one in my life. I mean, if I have taken an IQ test, it was like in kindergarten or something.
But I wonder if they're sending stuff out or something.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Well, who knows?
But I've gotten one a couple years ago. People are always like, "I'll take this test, IQ."
And it works.
How'd you do?
91. Which I hear
Steve's. So you got?
I got a 91, yeah.
Oh, my.
91. That's solid. So I hear that's good.
Did you just not read it properly, maybe? Did someone give it to you verbally when 160?
I told my wife, look.
Read it to me.
Read it to me because I can't read it.
So you got a 91 with her reading it
No. Okay. She wouldn't read it to me. Right. She said, no, you just take it. My reading skills are poor. Well, I can actually read okay, but I can't really make sense of things that I read.
Yes.
They don't make sense to me.
Yeah, it's visual processing. Yeah.
Yes, I have to have somebody
you
read it to me.
Actually hear it. Yeah.
Right. So, but, you know, 91, respectable.
Do
Roger?
Do you read out loud to yourself?
No, he has his servants read to him.
Oh, I have people read to me, yes. And if I have to make sense of something, I will read it out loud. But even then, I can't do it. Somebody has to read it out loud to me.
How many points above retardation is that?
91? 91 is like a full 7 points over...
Average.
Over
average.
Idiot.
Yeah. Isn't the 80s average like that?
I thought... I don't know.
100 is average.
100? Yeah, that's right. You get the breakdown.
You're supposed to be.
The 100 is.
Is it?
Yeah, the 100 is the bell curve. Middle.
No. Let's look it up on there.
Come on, 91.
Is it?
91, very solid.
What is it?
Very solid. Very
what's
solid.
What's he saying?
Roger, listen.
Yeah, Mark says 100. We all say 100. All Mark went to USC.
All right.
But Mark's a professor. He knows.
Listen, 91's fine. Look, if you get a test and you get a 91 on a test, it's a test, right? What do you get? An A. An A.
No.
Yeah.
B.
You get an A if you get a 91.
91's an A-.
But in this case, 100 is out of 100.
93
that's
was
right.
mine.
That's up. I rest my case.
100's a C in this case.
I rest my case. You get a 91 on a test. This is the word test is right in it. IQ test. I get a 91. That's A minus material.
Please, that was
thank
a B
you
plus
very much.
For me in school.
Thank
my
you.
My curve is a lot higher.
Roger.
Hi. First, I just want to say hi to Leanne. I have the FHM edition. It's really nice.
Roger that.
You
thank
see why
you.
Roger reminded me of the IQ test?
Yes.
And you don't want to lock mental antlers with me, Sweet Pea. I'll tell you a new a-hole with this 91 brain of mine.
Got a little theme going here.
91 octane, baby. That's why they call it 91. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's high octane.
Hi, Roger.
High octane, 91. Go ahead, Roger.
Before I ask my question, I was just wondering if you'd play the Taboo song sometime in the show.
No.
No?
You want Adam to sing to you, Leanne? He will.
Yeah, I'll sing Leanne the theme from Taboo, too.
She doesn't know what that is.
Oh, wait.
That's one of my all-time favorite porno movies.
He sang to me last time. Okay. It has to be the same song, isn't it?
Yeah. Roger, do you remember that last time?
Yeah, I'm trying to get down all the lyrics, but I'm not sure if I have it all.
I know, but did I sing the theme to Taboo 2?
I think you did.
You must have if she remembers it.
All right. I'm just wondering why Roger's
bringing
it up.
Actually, I think they dimmed the lights and you walked out.
Nice.
Mm. I remember you pulling your hair.
Yeah, that too. Right.
All right.
Secretary.
Anyway, Roger, what's up? Oh, the glasses. Yeah.
Yes.
What's up, Roger?
All right. My question is, I just started dating this girl about a month ago, and last week she started giving me oral.
Yeah.
And but when she gives the BJs, they're really aggressive, and it's like really hard for me to come. And then about a day or so ago, I was trying to masturbate, and I couldn't get an erection.
She hurt you?
Yeah, and I was just wondering if she damaged anything internally.
How long
is
ago?
That possible?
Yeah, it's possible, but
to an aggressive BJ?
I mean, you would have symptoms. You would feel something painful during it, and there would be some swelling.
Well, what was she doing?
She was. I mean, she just sucked. I mean, it really hard, and I mean, it was aggressive. And I told her that it was.
No. We're not really buying it. I don't know. Hard sucking. Nah. Come on, Roger.
Wait, what?
No, he's fine. I don't trust this kid.
Guys are screwballs, girls aren't, see?
Yeah.
The first caller turned out to be the real
thing. Come on, you can't say that. There's got to be some girls that would call and
we had
that.
One once call and get us just to prove that there was someone.
Yeah.
Are you going to tell me that girl's getting five times and she's giggling about it and it's funny and I don't believe it. I don't believe it. My BS factor went.
I have trouble believing it, but...
Well... Listen, you have a couple of great minds over here to basically decipher these calls. Solid 91. Drew, I don't know where you're at. You got it. You're probably in the high 80s.
How long did it take
low 90s yourself. Took me about like a 20, 25 minutes.
Wow.
Is there a time limit?
I don't. Is there?
It said the time.
Yeah.
It said that if you took more time, it would be worse than not doing a question. Like, if there's some question you're spending too much time on, you should move on.
Okay.
Yeah, so me reading every question and using my finger.
And then trying to read it out loud again.
Yeah, probably not a great thing. But, you know, hey, I stand by it. First off, nothing wrong with average intelligence. That's average. Nothing wrong with that. I mean, when I was in high school, what's an average grade? A C?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I could have gone for that.
Oh, then, yeah.
Hey, Drew, it sounds like he's trying to justify himself.
He's rationalizing
tonight a lot.
Nothing wrong with a big 91.
100 is the average.
100's the average?
Looked it up?
Yeah, that's in the realm of average. I got nowhere to go but up, by the way. Maybe I get 94, 95 next time I take it. Know what I'm saying? All right. Let's take ourselves a break. Leanne, what's that, Drew?
I'm trying to figure out how IQs can have a stable average. I mean, it's got to change with time.
Sure.
Do they arbitrarily set it at 100 or per given population readings? I don't understand that.
Well,
all right, anyway.
Okay. And what? And they just have tests for 10-year-olds, too? Can't you have an IQ test when you're 5 or something? I
got
to take that one. That's the one I got to get. All right. Leanne Tween, our guest tonight. She's on 54321, Extreme Sports Show on Fox Sports West. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody, it's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Leanne Tweeden is our guest tonight. She's the host of 54321. That's on Fox Sports Net's new extreme sports show. And it is that, I should say. It's the pluralization that drives me nuts here. I remember it last time. The Fox Sports Net's. Always feel like I'm stumbling a little there.
Essence.
But weekdays, 5:30. It's It's extreme sports. You got your high half pipes and your snowboards and your guys on dirt bikes and all the
surfing
good stuff.
And surfing. BMX, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that stuff's good. Big wave surfing's very exciting.
Mm. Very cool. I just got back from Hawaii.
You did?
Yeah. We were on the North Shore a lot.
Was there war there? Because I'm going. No war?
No.
No.
No. A lot of military, though.
Yay! I want to go to Hawaii!
Yeah. Speaking of that, by the way, well, crank yankers, I'm going to Michigan. I'm going to Detroit, Michigan.
Sorry.
When? For what?
2 a.m. on Friday.
For what?
Because Eminem is in love with crank yankers, and he wants to do phone calls. And we got to go out there and meet him in Detroit. Yeah, I know. It sounds crazy,
kinda
right?
It's kind of cool, though.
It's kind of cool, except for the part where you're leaving at 2 a.m. To go to Detroit, and you come home Sunday and go to work.
I have a million questions.
Yeah.
No flights leave L.A. You guys taking a private jet or something?
No. No, there's
nothing leaves after 12:30.
There's like a Northwest flight that leaves at 2 a.m. To Detroit.
And then why does this have to be in Detroit?
I guess that's where Eminem is.
Are you forming a video of this, or are you getting him to do crank anchor calls?
He wants to do calls.
So you're just going out there to meet him.
So you're taking your production
initial.
Team?
Yeah, I'm just going out there to write jokes and, you know.
Just the usual, John and those guys, your usual
production. Our normal crank yanker crew. I think Jimmy's going,
too. Oh, so you're actually going to do a show while you're out there.
A crank yanker.
Going to record episode. Calls.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, gotcha.
That's right, with the great Eminem. And he's going to be with Special Ed. He wants to do ones with Special Ed,
really?
Who... just wanted to go to Hawaii.
Right.
So that's going to be interesting. All very exciting, except for the part where on Friday night you get to go to Detroit at 2 a.m. All right. Let's move forward here and speak to Sergio, who's 17. Sergio?
Hello. Adam, Dr. Drew, and Leanne.
Hi.
I'm kind of nervous.
All right.
I wanted to know if Leanne liked doing Blue Torch better than 5-4-3-2-1. Like, I know, like, on 5-4-3-2-1, like, it's, like, a new show and everything, but, like, with Blue Torch, you guys got to, like, travel and everything.
Yeah, totally. I love Blue Torch for that because the world was my office. I was everywhere. But we're actually getting out of the studio now from 5-4-3-2-1 and going to be traveling around a lot more, so...
Blue Torch was the same kind of show, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the same type of sports you covered,
mm-hmm.
right?
And it was an hour-long show. It was a little bit different format, but same sort of stuff.
Yeah.
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 And I have another question. I was wondering if you knew about the core tour.
Hold on. This is the guy who sounds the crank yanker sounding guy.
No.
That's what he sounds like.
Say crank yanker, Sergio.
What's up?
No.
Say crank yankers.
Crank yankers?
No. Crank yanker.
See, it's different.
All right. What's marginal?
I want to know if you guys knew or Leanne knew about the core tour coming up like next week.
Yeah, you know, I don't know much about... What's your question?
I actually wanted to know, like, if you guys would do a segment over there.
You know, we probably actually are sending people. I am going to be going back to Virginia before I leave for my USO trip, so I'm not going to be in town. But I'm sure somebody will be down there from our show.
All right.
Are you going to go?
Yeah, it's because, like, my birthday is this Monday coming up, and I wanted to know, like, if I would have, like, met you in person over there. Or
no. She's going to Virginia, then she's going to go see some troops.
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
Iraq, right?
All right. Yeah, you can meet her in Iraq. All right?
A rendezvous in Kuwait.
Yeah, good times. All right. Hey, are you saying you're going to Iraq? Is that where you're going?
Kuwait and Iraq, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's beautiful.
No, not to Iraq.
Beautiful.
Be interesting.
Beautiful country. It's beautiful people. Hey, and, you know, good news, too. They got the Palestinian guy, and they got... Ariel Sharon and what the hell's his name?
Jordan.
Yeah, Jordan. They got all the guys together. Apparently, they're going to hammer out this whole Middle East thing. Mm-hmm. No problems over there anymore. Palestinians and Jews, Jewish settlers.
Oh, ye of little faith.
It's going to work out fine. No problems. They've agreed. They've agreed on some things.
I heard
over
them
there.
Say good times.
Yeah, good times. They met on a lawn. They shook hands. It's going to work out. Just, you know. Like they did with Carter.
You know what, though? Well, I'll tell you what.
Oh, it's the same guys.
Part of that, No. Part of that did work out, and that was Egypt and Israel, and no one believed they could live together.
Yeah. Listen, here's the thing about the Middle East. Pack of horrible people all trying to live on top of each other.
You know what?
Of course.
Oh.
They're going to fight. They want to fight.
Don't stereotype. That's not nice.
I think it's all the...
What do you mean? What do you mean stereotype? Do the math.
It's all the trauma. The trauma they inflict on one another. And
whatever it is. Yeah. They're breeds of dogs that like to fight. That's it. Is it stereotyping to say there's a difference between a Rottweiler and a Golden Retriever? Is that stereotyping? That's dog stereotyping? No. One's a nastier breed.
That's yeah, but not all Rottweilers are bad.
Not all of them. Just a much, much, much higher percentage than
Drew,
Labradors.
Help me out here.
A much higher percentage than Labradors, and that's all
dig.
It takes.
Let him dig.
That's not all the same people. It's all the same. It's all the same. Middle East, it's all the same people. No, they'll be fine. They'll get right along over there. Yeah, this will be great. Like, they'll blow up a few more things, and it'll go on forever. It'll keep going on because everyone's nuts over there, right. And they're, they like to fight.
The last blow up.
They like to fight. That's all right. Just admit you like to fight, and everyone blow each other up. That's fine. You just fence off the whole place. See what I'm talking about?
Wow.
Dog's right there.
That's no Labrador. Pat?
Oh, my God.
Pat?
Hello?
You're 20.
What happened there?
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that.
What happened?
Across the street, we're bargain. I just wanted to call and let you know that I took one of those internet IQ tests before.
Yeah. Yeah, can you beat 91, Tuts? I don't think so.
It said that I got a 121.
Oh,
nice.
Then I took the test again, and I changed all my answers, and it still said I had a 121.
See how good those tests are?
Yeah, they're really wonderful.
They knew exactly what your IQ was without, even with you trying to cheat.
It's psychic IQ tests.
All right.
The internet's come a long way, so I just want to let you know,
Yeah.
Personally, I think you're a lot smarter than,
Hey, listen, I'm pretty happy with my 91. I got no problems with that. It could have been lower. Let's be honest. Could have been into the 40s. Pat?
My friend called in the other night, and she forgot to tell you she loves you. Hmm. So she just wanted me to tell you now.
Very important.
Yeah. Whatever.
This is going to be my new way of going through life. I just tell I get myself a windbreaker. It says 91 IQ on it. People are nice. They're forgiving. you're people telling me they love me. Forgetting about that. What kind of dogs were fighting next door?
I think they're white labs.
Aha! I told you. Wait a minute.
Those aren't the
You're
nasty.
Screwing my story.
Exactly.
How dare you, Pat? All right, so you come in, you call up, you rub your 121 in my mug, and now you bring your lab thing up and screw my example with Leanne up?
I'm just a horrible person. I'm sorry.
No.
Right. Maybe you need
horrible.
To take another IQ test, like another random one, just to kind of sort of... See
right,
what else
right.
there is out there. Kind of do a few of them, maybe. There's a few different ones out there.
Mm-hmm. Well,
man's actually feeling sorry.
I know everyone feels sorry.
I am.
True.
I'm sorry.
Who thinks they're a genius more than I do?
Well,
you know anybody?
I haven't noticed that the recent objective data has changed your opinion any.
Thank you, Sandra.
Yeah.
You're 25.
Uh huh.
What's up?
Well, first of all, I'm a special ed teacher and interpret IQ tests every day. So mm-hmm.
interesting. Mm-hmm.
You are just. Fine.
91.
That's nice of her to say. And she's a special ed teacher.
Compared to her special ed
nice.
Students, Adam, you're doing great.
Yeah. What's an average special ed number?
Special ed number?
Yeah.
70, 80.
Yeah. Yeah.
You got 11 on those kids, pal.
Yeah.
That's wow. Awesome.
Read it and weep,
run
kiddies.
Run for president.
Yeah, and against my better judgment, I love special ed on Cranky Anchors.
Oh, yeah.
But I would never say that professionally.
I want to go to Hawaii. Yay.
Yay.
Yay. I want to go to Hawaii.
Yeah.
All right. So,
but
you
I
hear that? Mid-80s as opposed to very low 90s.
Right.
Big difference. Big
right.
difference.
Big difference. Huge.
Well, you did have some special ed issues.
It's a huge chasm between, let's say, 86 and 91. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's a whole different room in the school.
Yeah. Thank you. That's right. That's right. And the bus is much longer.
Much longer.
Thank you.
All right, Sandra, what's going on?
All right, well, I just have a question. I mean, I hear calls all the time about, people who are really abused and now have sexual problems.
Yeah.
And I wasn't abused or anything like that. I just had a bad first sexual experience. And now I'm having trouble enjoying sex. And so I'm just wondering if it's something that seems as mild as that can affect me now.
How old were you?
I was 15.
Yeah. Yeah. How old was the guy?
He was 17.
Hmm. And what was bad? I mean, other than you didn't enjoy it, maybe it was uncomfortable.
Yeah, I didn't want to, and it wasn't rape or anything like that, but it was, we'd gone out for a year, and he just really, you know, for lack of a better phrase, laid into me about, you know, oh, you know, you're not doing this, and you're not doing that, and I'm not happy, and so finally I just said, fine, okay, go ahead, and, you know, it was painful, and
go
it wasn't.
Ahead.
Yeah, yeah, all right.
Isn't that different female interpretation?
Okay, so you're 15, mm-hmm. a little young, but not by Loveline standards.
But and possibly traumatizing, right?
Possibly, but you went out with a guy for a year.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a long time at 15.
Yeah, but right. again, yeah. But she may have been a 15-year-old that really wasn't ready for this.
I do agree with that, but it shouldn't screw you up for sex for, you know, I mean, it's been 10 years.
Well, it makes me wonder if she has sort of a post-traumatic stress reaction. In other words, had something previously sort of set you up to be sensitive to trauma?
No, I mean, not that I know of. I mean,
I'm not talking about necessarily overt sexual abuse. Yeah.
Parent die, something
right,
like that.
Right.
No, nothing like that.
And then that kind of activates it again?
Yeah. Well, listen, Sandra.
Uh-huh.
Couple thoughts.
Okay.
Maybe you're just one of these people that ain't into sex that much. I know it sounds so overly simplistic, but I mean, first off, how much do you like guys?
A lot.
You do. Okay, and you
and you're attracted to them, and you.
Oh yeah.
But you,
oh, yeah.
I
get turned on and everything.
Do you have successful relationships?
Yeah, actually, I'm married. Yeah.
And it's good.
And it's good.
And you've never enjoyed sex.
No, well, I get turned on, and I can have orgasms, but it's like when we actually get to the sex, I'm like, oh, okay, hurry up. I want to get this over with.
Is it like you're anxious?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is like post-traumatic stress, right?
But also there's an establishment of, like, sometimes you know, like when there's a word you decide you can't pronounce, and then you mispronounce it three times, and then that's it. It's over. Mm-hmm. You think about it every time
yeah.
it comes up, and you just mispronounce it in advance. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds like that's what Sandra's doing with sex, in a sense.
It's almost a phobia, a little phobic of it because of that original.
Yeah, it's like you had a rough outing the first time. It wasn't rape. It wasn't full-on abuse, but it was a bad outing. And then you fixated on it, and then you decided each and every time it was going to be bad, and lo and behold, it is.
Yeah.
Do you drink?
No. I thought that's what you recommend for her.
Oh, yeah. Booze it up, baby.
Yeah, that does help.
Relax a little.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know what? Go into your next encounter with, hey, I'm with a guy I love.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to enjoy myself.
What
I'm
does your
gonna...
husband say?
He worries a little bit. I mean, he's very sexual, and he's very attractive. And I'm, like I said, I'm always, you know, talking about sex, and I want to have sex with you, and then I just can't do it.
Wow.
So...
All right. Booze it up. Couple of wine coolers and some.
There was a movie like that.
What?
What was it?
I don't remember the name of it. I think Natasha Kinski. No. A long time ago, and a guy like loved her so much in the movie. I don't remember because it was so long ago. But like, he couldn't make love to her. He loved her so much. It was like weird that when it came time to actually physically doing it, he couldn't.
Hmm. Oh.
I don't know.
Yeah, that's the adventures of Gay Gaiman. Because she's hot. Yeah. Yeah. Let's see another guy in the 91 Club come up with. Gay Gaiman is my gay name.
It's good.
Yeah.
Very creative.
That's good, right, Drew?
120.
That's thinking on your feet.
Woo.
Very
that's,
creative.
That's
you
and
all the special people.
That's
Adam.
That's like one high teens, low 20s. That's where you got to be to come up with that kind of stuff. Leanne Tweeden is our guest tonight. She's currently the host of 54321 on Fox Sports Net. We will take ourselves a little break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody, it's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Leanne Tweeden is our guest tonight, host of 54321 on Fox Sports Net. Drew?
Just looked up a site. It said it should take, average IQ, these online tests should take about 12 minutes.
12 minutes. All right, what'd I tell you? It took me.
25.
Now, is it a question like, you know, check A or check B for any question?
32 questions, 12 minutes, it says.
32 questions, 12 minutes.
I mean, is it multiple choice, or do you have to actually fill in an answer?
No, it's just A or B, pretty much.
Okay.
Seemed like you'd have a 50-50 shot of getting something right.
Drew, you going to take one?
Yeah, Drew, go take one.
12 minutes.
12 minutes. Who needs you? We don't know you're gone. Show's better when you're not here.
Do it?
Yeah, take
Anderson
form.
Anderson wants me to do it.
Anderson says yes. Yeah. And it, Here's the thing. You can't break it up, right? You can't put
so
on pause.
Five minutes left in this segment. I'll try to do it in 9 minutes.
Okay, yeah, Drew, you've been taking
Show
tests
off.
Your whole life. You can do that.
12 minutes from right now, we're back.
Show off.
We are?
All right. Anderson's saying 12 minutes from now, we come back after the break. Yeah, you can go ahead and take it, Drew. All right.
Can we get a little mood lighting again now that you're gone?
Yeah.
It's the second time he's left us when I've been here.
Oh, yes, he does. Yeah. Taboo too. He knows how to please in every detail. They're singing about a gentleman who is not only having sex with his sister, but with his mom as well. Then you'd ever imagine and do it with style. He does it with me. Oh, yes, he does. His name's Junior. Have you seen Taboo 2?
I'm afraid not.
Great
movie. Not part of my collection.
Great movie. Yeah, here's a good line. Well, maybe you did, but you don't. That's where I do a whole body movement thing. He only reveals what he wants you to see and then shows it all. And when he does, he satisfies me. It's unclear whether it's the mom or the sister who's singing here. He also has a girlfriend he's doing, too. Here's a big crescendo here. You'd want him to if you only knew. Yeah, thank you.
And you're still married?
Yeah.
God bless her.
Taboo too. I'll tell you, it was the best night of my life. John from System of a Down was here. I found out he had Taboo too. I hadn't seen this movie in 15 years.
I remember you told me that last time. He actually called in, remember? And he said he had the copy of the tape for you or whatever.
Yeah,
drove
over to his house in Van Nuys and went and got it. That's how committed I am.
Lovely.
Dave?
Yeah?
You're 23?
I am.
So Drew's taking the IQ test. Good luck beating 91. Let's be honest.
And he said, he goes, nah, I'll do it in 9 minutes.
Yeah.
That was a little rub, I think.
He's a fast reader. He likes to make fun of me just because I don't read. But I say that's not the only test of intelligence, your reading speed. Dave, what do you say?
Very true, very true. I just finished up a psych course, so I just thought I'd give you a little insight on your test. You're dead center. I mean, 100 is the average score, but it goes to one standard deviance, which is 15 points either way.
That's right. So 85, nothing wrong with that.
Everybody likes that curve.
Yeah.
Just to make you feel okay.
Two standard deviance either way determines whether you're overly smart or in the retarded stage.
Well, when do I get down
to... Ed.
I mean, I'm a good solid 9 points away from retarded, right?
11,
I think.
Was when they determine, yeah.
I thought she said 71 to 80 or something. And,
all right.
You know,
so I'm up
you're
there.
You're a solid 91.
91. Solid.
Get in there, man.
All right, Dave. Thanks a lot, buddy.
No problem.
Nothing wrong with that. People make a big deal out of triple-digit IQs. I don't got anything to prove. You know what I'm saying, baby doll? First off, I got the look. You know what I mean?
Mm.
What do I need my brain for? Look at me. Look at the look.
I'm looking.
I got the look. You know
what look
I got
is
the
that,
look?
Adam? Just describe to everyone your look.
Ow! My look is kind of young, kind of wow, kind of hip, kind of now. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I got a good look. And the next thing is I got my own style. I got my own attitude. You know, you see, I wear the muckluck boots with no socks and the pants I wore for 3 days in a row. That's my
and
thing.
And the beard you've worn for three days in a row.
Got a little,
the
little,
shirt you
little,
worn for
little
three
growth,
days.
Little growth gone. Nothing wrong with that. I got my own style. I got my own. It's what you call flair, panache. That should be a word on that test. I know what that means. Eric.
Yeah.
You're 28.
That's me.
What's going on?
Well, I'm considering getting a vasectomy, but what I wanted to know is a little bit more about the male birth control pill.
Yeah. We don't know that much about it. I'm speaking for Dr. Drew since he's out taking the test.
Well, you got a good IQ score, so I trust you.
Yeah, well, like I said, most doctors, I think in the high 70s, low 80s probably. So you're talking to a 91er over here.
Okay.
As far as the male birth control pill goes, they've been working on it for a long time. They're getting closer. Doing some tests in England or something like that, the last we heard, and nothing available yet here in the United States. And I think it's gonna lead to more pregnancies, and I'm using my superhuman brain because guys are going to say they're on the pill when they're not. Are you?
Do you want to be on the male birth control pill because you don't want to put on a condom every time?
Well, no. I mean, I don't mind putting on a condom. It's just that I have a latex allergy, so it makes buying them much harder.
Don't they make sheepskin ones or something or natural skin? I don't know.
Well, they do, but they're twice the price. That's the thing, you know. And
well, listen, Eric.
Oh, come on,
Eric. How often are you getting laid? Twice a year?
Oh, feels like it.
Yeah. So, at an extra 40 cents a pop, what's that?
Do you rather pay twice the price for those than to have AIDS or a venereal disease?
That's right. You know how much AIDS cost?
Actually, that's not really my big concern. My big concern is that I have a child from a previous relationship in which my condom broke.
All right. All right. So you're not currently in a relationship?
I am.
You are. So why don't you get her on the birth control pill?
Well, she was on it before, but it was having some weird adverse effects.
Well, she should
change it up.
She should get
talk
it
to your doctor.
Get it adjusted, yeah. She should be able to dial that in. All right, tell her to dial it in, Eric.
Just dial it in, huh?
Yeah, well, look, you guys are having a relationship. You want to have frequent intercourse. The condoms aren't working well for you. Plus, you've got a condom kid already, so it's really...
It might take a little work, but
it's... Kind of bad luck. She needs to go back to her doctor and get her
it
adjusted. There's many different types, that's all.
Take a little Vicodin tonight, take some codeine, smoke a little heroin.
No, true. Please, please, focus on the test. Focus now, buddy. Leanne Tweeden in here tonight from Fox Sports Net. We will take ourselves a quick break. We'll be right back. Hello. Thank you.
There you are.
Phone number. It's Loveline. Phone number is 1-800-LOVE-191. Leanne Tweeden is our guest tonight. She's the super foxy broad who's on 54321. That's on Fox Sports Nets. Fox Sports Net. Thank you. Dr. Drew went into the next room to take his IQ test, and then we went and paid him a visit during the break, and I thought he was at the bottom of the test.
No, he still had to scroll down. I saw that right as I was running back over here.
Oh. There was like 30 questions or something? I thought he was on like 25 or something.
No, he still had a few more to go.
All right. Well, when he, it looked like the same test I scored a stellar 91 on earlier tonight at home, so Drew will come in here and we'll compare numbers. But like I said, good luck. Leanne is going to be heading off to the Middle East to say hi to the troops. She is showing me what she signed for the boys, 5-6 different patriotic pictures, all in her underpants, which is delightful.
Bikini.
Very tasteful, very nice.
Get on your knees, scumbag!
That was good.
Land of the free, home of the brave. How long do you stay there when you go on these USA trips?
Usually it's about 2 weeks, but this trip particularly will be about 5 days.
And what besides like autograph signing and sort of touring areas, is there anything else you do there?
No, that's about it. But I mean that consumes your whole day. There's so many thousands of troops over there that you get to a particular base and you get up first thing in the morning, you go eat, and then it's off. Basically,
where do you thousands. Stay when you go out in the theater that way?
Well, that's good. You know that word. When I went to Afghanistan and Oman and Pakistan.
Come on, I know a lot of words.
There
yeah.
you go. Ooh, 91 IQ, I remember.
Mm-hmm.
We stayed on base. We stayed in a DV tent, designated visitors tent, and we showered with the rest of the girls, and the guys that were with us showered with the guys. And
nice.
I mean, it was very... Yeah. You know, we were in.
They must have to keep like an MP standing at the foot of your bed.
In Afghanistan,
time.
We had 24 hours on us.
Yeah. You want some crazy.
I think they were more worried about us getting out and roaming around Afghanistan because it was still kind of dangerous around that area. So they didn't want us kind of roaming.
They were worried about
unexploded landmines.
They're worried
stuff.
About drunken jarheads raving you. That's what they're worried about. Drew, you took the test. 120. Uh-oh.
Testing, what is it? Here.
120.
Did that mean you got every question right?
I don't know.
No, listen.
Like
I got horrible news. Okay. I got horrible news. My wife got 121.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's bad
good.
News for you, too.
That's good. She's smart.
What, she's borderline retarded. What are you talking about?
Yeah,
smart.
She married you, right?
No, she's not. She's all right.
I figured I'd be about 120. That's about
I'm just telling you, my wife... Drew, if your wife scores better than you and me, then there's going to be real
trouble.
I got
a question, Drew. What do you think about the IQ test? I mean, some people might not be as smart as others and they're successful. No, I mean, what is that to base what on?
We were just talking about this during one of the breaks. Is that a lot?
That's a short 29 points you did better than me. That's, you know, that's almost nothing. If that were a football game, that'd be a very close game.
No, that's really only 15 points, right? Or 14 points because you get the extra 15 on the back end.
You're playing a football game and the score's 21-50. That's a close game. You know what I'm
saying?
College ball, everyone knows that.
Yeah, or baseball.
Or arena football.
Arena.
Come on.
All right, go ahead.
There's a lot of controversy about what IQ means, and there's more and more emphasis being placed on EQ, emotional.
We got to take one of those tests.
And I was telling Adam, I said if they had had a spatial sort of test, I mean, I'd get a zero. And he would get a very, very high score. He can create things and build things.
Don't patronize me.
No, it's true.
Don't patronize me.
So it's not entirely clear what we're looking at. And how much does education come to bear on it versus some other kind of experience?
And I was talking to a group
of very, very successful businessmen. And one of the guys pulled me aside and he goes, you know, when you're talking to these guys, you got to be really clear. Give them 10 points because they all have ADD and they all got C's in college. And we have a saying in our organization that the B's work for the C's and the A's teach.
Ooh.
Wow.
What do the D's do?
They do radio.
And what are the professors?
Thank you.
Teachers.
Kimberly?
Yes.
You're 29?
Yes.
What's up?
I am 36 and a half weeks pregnant.
Mm-hmm. That's 4 years. Right?
I don't enjoy sex at this point in time.
All right.
36 weeks. All right.
Interestingly,
some women at the end of the pregnancy get very aroused. The pressure.
Yeah, you know what I hear? Between that and it helps to induce labor with some women.
It's one of God's great jokes. He's laughing about that one still.
Yeah.
I'm very interested in it. It's just when it comes time to it, it's just like, oh my God, I don't want to do that.
Because like a big turnoff?
Well, I think maybe part of it's because I get so close and I can't orgasm.
Mm-hmm. Hold on, but she's almost due, right? How many weeks are you pregnant?
36 and a half. So four more weeks. I only have, three weeks left.
My girlfriend has about two, and she's just ready to get it out.
Yeah. Well, the point is, okay, so you don't want sex the last couple of weeks of your pregnancy.
I've been
fine.
I'm wondering about the safety of using a vibrator.
It's fine, provided you don't have a complicated pregnancy. I mean, if they're not worried about preterm labor... That's all right.
I think you make your kids stutter if you do that, though.
There's that, of course.
Yeah.
Are you saying you think you'll climax when you have a vibrator so you feel better and you feel relieved?
I was hoping that that would
happen. Not frustrated anymore?
Yeah. So I don't have to go chew ice or something.
All right.
But I didn't know about the safety, and I...
You're fine.
I'm fine.
You're not having any preterm labor?
No, I'm not having any problems.
You
should be fine.
There's a mild Down syndrome that occurs with women that use but this is more the C and D cell batteries.
That causes it?
Yeah, it's not the little pen light one.
So you have to use a smaller one?
Yeah, the pocket rocket's fine. It's the big Panasonic ones that you plug in. The ones where the lights dim when you turn it up. You know, it's like,
are the ones attached to your car battery?
Yeah, the one you put the jumper cables, the alligator clips on. It's like the ones that look like, you know what the prison looks like when they fry someone in the electric chair and see all the lights getting in?
Yeah, flutter.
I kind of think that's a movie thing. I got to believe if you're going to pump, you know, 100,000 volts through somebody, you just go ahead and break down, put another circuit in. You know, like, really? Should the whole prison dim?
Blink,
all the lights. Like everything's on one. You build a prison, you put everything on one breaker. The warden fires up his hot plate. The whole place goes out. Got to shove some foil in there. All right.
Yeah.
All right. That's called artistic license. Chloe?
Yeah?
You're 18?
Yeah.
What's up?
Okay. I was just wondering because I think probably a little while ago I took the morning after pill.
Mm-hmm.
And my period came like a week and a half early. And I was wondering about that because it hasn't been like normal. It's sort of been like light and not like all the way, like I'll start to bleed and then like I'll stop for like a day and then it'll start again. And it's
so
like,
this is your normal period now occurring on the month following the month you took the EC?
Well, actually it came, I've had it for like 7-8 days now, like on and off.
But this is the normal time in which you would be getting your period?
No. It's way early.
Way early.
I usually shouldn't be getting
You're not having your period. You're just having some mid-cycle bleeding from the emergency contraception. It's normal.
And that's really normal?
You're not.
It's not like birth control. A lot of people have spot bleeding throughout the month. Yeah. It's just.
Why do women get so surprised by that? I have trouble sort of relating to that.
I have that problem sometimes.
But when you when it first happened, was it like a huge shock? I mean, you're taking
It made me mad.
I don't want to deal with this.
Right. Yeah. I mean, sometimes it would be almost the entire month. Mm. You know, and then talking about going back to your doctor and switching up and just finding what works for your body.
So you were taking the low-dose pill to begin with.
Drew, let's not talk about the period as it pertains to Leanne. I think we're sort of filled with that.
You think I'm like a Barbie doll in plastic and
marshmallows?
Here's what I picture inside
of
you.
Adam, guess what? I pee too.
Mm-mm. No.
You believe it?
No.
Mm-mm.
Man.
I picture you being filled with those like styrofoam peanuts. And
fluff.
With just a little marmalade spackled in there. Just for a little texture. You know what I'm saying? All right. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
That's what I'm feeling. Hey, listen, I want to talk to Katie. We got Katie and Jerry over here. They've been on hold for a combined 4 hours. Katie?
Yeah.
You're 23?
Yep.
You have a rape anniversary coming up?
Yeah. I just want to throw in one little thing, though.
Mm-hmm.
You guys are making me feel really, really good about my 147 on the IQ.
Yeah.
You got a 147?
Wow, you go, girl.
Yeah.
Really? Yeah, that's...
It was one of those official ones, so not...
That's marginally better than my 91.
She's like, it was an official one, not one on the internet. Thanks,
the
guys.
No.
Go,
yeah.
Girl.
And so you got a 147. What happened with the rape?
Well, it wasn't the emotional IQ. That was 23 months ago to the date.
Hold on. How many months?
Almost 2 years.
23 months.
2 years. July 4th.
All right.
Okay, but that's a no anniversary. But go ahead.
Last year I had a lot of problems with it, and I had a lot of support last year. This year it's just me.
Well, what happened with the rape?
It was a first date kind of thing, and I said yes to certain things, and that kind of...
So this is, again, back to the idea of a post-traumatic stress reaction, a reactivation of something else.
Yeah.
So what happened when you were younger?
I don't know. It's been hypothesized that something might have happened.
That's the only way this all works. It's the only way you can sort of figure out why you developed a post-traumatic stress disorder from something that's awful, but it was a date rape, and most people sort of manage the feelings associated with that over a period of time.
Well, was it a brutal thing?
No, but the thing is, fireworks set off really bad
panic attacks.
Yep,
panic attacks, flashbacks. Mm-hmm. That's all post-traumatic stress disorder.
And the flashbacks, though, they're not like...
Hold on, did she say fireworks?
It was 4th of July, so it's all at the same time.
I see.
She has flashbacks now.
But you said yes to certain things, right? You said, so you went to a certain extent, and then he took it farther than you... When you said no, he still went on?
Yeah, he didn't hear no the first 30 times.
Well, then, now, did you call the cops?
Yeah, the DA as well. I don't think I convinced the jury. That's it kind of thing.
Yeah.
Because you said yes to a lot of stuff. Do you think that's why?
I didn't say yes to that much.
Oh, I thought you said you agreed to some things.
Come on, Leanne. Don't put words in
your
mouth.
No. I thought she said that. Did you not say you... Yeah, she did say that.
She's 147. You can't corner her. She's like a mental cat. You understand? She's elusive.
The problem with the hallucinations, though,
Hold on a second. Is your phone screwed up, or are you just... What's going on with you? Is this a bad line we have, Katie?
No, it's her.
Cell phone. Sorry.
Okay. All right. So here's the deal. What happened to you recently is something to look into, but it's not the main thing to look into. The main thing to look into is whatever happened to you recently, what that uncovered, what was there before, and what caused that, what the origins of that is and was, and that's probably going to take some therapy and some exploration.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So how about it, Katie?
I've been told not to try to get into that and just kind of move on and try to...
Yeah, but the problem is this popped the cap on it.
Yeah. I'm sure they didn't tell you just to move on. What they told you was it probably is not useful to dig into the traumas of the past, but therapy can be useful. Now, go ahead. Have some therapy.
All right.
Because the idea is to keep you less reliant on these primitive mechanisms that have sort of taken over now. Mm-hmm. And re-evoking all the feelings of the original trauma doesn't do much except intensify some of those feelings.
Drew, you got 120, she got 147. I don't think
Yeah, but I guess she should be listening. Celebrating the anniversary every year is not going to make that better.
No.
Right?
No. Jerry?
Yeah.
You're 21?
Yeah.
You want to know how long after a possible exposure to herpes it may crop up?
Yeah.
We were just talking about this the other night.
Yeah, it can be very occasionally will happen the next day, but on average, you get a prodrome, some sort of aches and pains and things within a week or so, and usually about 2 weeks out, you get the rash.
So, I didn't have sex with her. I just ate her out.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Where did you go to finishing school? Sir Walter Raleigh.
I'm guessing somewhere in Europe.
Yeah, I imagine. Switzerland, I bet.
Switzerland.
Yeah.
Switzerland? Where'd you go to finishing school, Jerry?
Cool.
Yeah. He's a double-digit man. I can smell it.
Triple, huh?
70?
No. I'm thinking double.
And what happened after this?
After what?
The eating out.
Well, this happened early in the morning. I had to leave to go skiing. So.
Oh, of course.
Right, but how long ago was this?
This was during Don Juan, too. He's so romantic.
Yeah. Hey, baby.
I gotta hit the slope. See
ya. Yeah. Thanks for the lick, but I gotta bust some
Where's my snowboard?
Yeah. All right.
So what happened after you left?
Well, actually, I'm also calling for my friend because she hooked up with one of my friends after I left.
Yeah. Wait, so I wanted to. Is he talking about having herpes in his mouth?
Are you having sores in your mouth?
No, I'm not.
Right, then who cares? Drew's always
what
right.
What was that all about?
I don't know.
No, he
you know I'm right. That's why I was not getting to those calls.
He did it semi-recently, and he wants to know if something's coming around the corner, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, let me just say. Jerry,
well,
how long ago did you perform this on this woman?
It was 3 months ago.
All right. Well, then we're done. Something would have shown up by now, Drew. I mean, what is the outside? If you got exposed to herpes, you were going to get herpes.
2 weeks. It's 2 weeks.
2 weeks outside.
But then once you get that, it never goes away,
it
right?
It keeps coming milder. The recurrences are typically milder, and they do sort of burn out over years. The recurrences get further and further apart, and eventually they stop.
Heather?
Yes, hi.
You're 23?
No, I'm 27.
That's right. That's what it says. What's up?
Yeah. 20 old, yeah. I was just calling because I was a school psychologist, and I thought maybe I could help you guys. Actually, I have an IQ test here in front of me, so I could ask you some, 10-year-old questions, or if you want to hit for some harder ones, I have some 14-year-old questions.
14. Adam, there's your enabler. She'll read them to you.
14's a little out of my range.
I know. No, it's just like, you guys seem like teenagers.
Yeah.
Your voices are like old.
All right. Why don't you give me the first one, and you can give Drew the second one, and give Leanne the third one.
Well, the 14-year-old one.
Oh, Lord.
Well, okay, I won't start with the 6-year-old questions, because it's like, how many...
No. Listen, I don't need the 16-year-old stuff. I want the 10-year-old stuff.
Okay, 10-year-old?
6-year-old. Yeah, 10-year-old.
All right, here we go. This is just general information.
Mm-hmm. What's your name?
What do you need to do to make water boil?
Oh, man. You got to get it angry.
I don't know.
That's a joke answer. Come on now. Give it up.
All right.
Well, there. This is my kind of test.
Yeah,
pretty
I know.
Well,
you
here.
Got it.
I'm on a roll. All right, you heat it. Yeah?
You heat it.
Put heat. Put heat in there. Okay, come on. Let me just do the next one.
Two kinds of coins for me.
What's that?
Two kinds of coins.
Two types of coins.
Coins. Quarter, a dime.
Just name them. Oh, okay, yeah, all right.
Dime,
and...
people look into it.
And the half dime. What's that half dime?
No, that was a vacant stare you saw.
It's a half dime. Story. Half a dime. 5 pennies. They got a name for it. Okay. All right, let's go up to the 14-year-old questions.
Okay, 14-year-old. Okay, this is a little harder. What does the stomach do?
You put the food in there. Yeah?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, it hangs over your belt buckle.
I like the way she answered it, too. Very good, Adam. That would be very smart. Very good idea.
I like the way you're thinking.
Yeah. It's like your body's Tupperware.
That's right.
That's right. You take the food out of the freezer, put it into the microwave, and then you put it in your tummy, and it's yummy, yummy, yummy.
Correct.
Okay, I can tell you're ready for a bigger one.
Give me a tough one.
All right, what's water made out of?
Oh, my God. That's it's part sugar and spice.
And everything nice.
Yeah. Well, you want the you want the atomic thing?
Yeah.
The technical, yes.
H2O, yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
Hey, let me ask you some really good questions, though.
What?
These are my favorite ones. All right.
So I got to be doing better than 91 on the 14-year-old test.
You're fine. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
You have very good verbal skills.
And when, what kind of school administers the IQ test? Because I don't remember that.
Every school does.
Yeah.
They all do now?
Mm-hmm. I remember taking them.
You don't give it to every kid.
Oh, you just give it to the tardos? Super tard and super smart?
I want to hear the favorite questions.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, well, these are my favorite ones. What are you supposed to do if a boy much smaller than yourself tries to fight with you?
You give him a good ass kicking. Or not if he's an Asian kid, because he's got no karate. You run. Chinese, Japanese kid, you run. He's got them nunchucks. He's got those throwing stars. Mexican kid's probably got a gun or a knife, maybe a zip gun. Black kid will take you out. But if it's a white kid, you kick his ass. All
right? Right.
All right.
That's definitely 2 points.
Thank you.
Again, I like how you're thinking, right?
Yeah. She likes my train of thought. I think you're right. All right. What are we doing here?
We're taking a break.
Heather, thanks for calling. I appreciate that. I really feel like I've salvaged my dignity with that.
Yeah.
Got that stomach question. I was right on with that.
This Tupperware for the body. I shall remember that always.
Mm-hmm. Leanne Tweeden is in studio tonight. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. Buddy, love line, Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Leanne Tweeden is our guest tonight. Phone number 1-800-LVE-191. Leanne can be found on 54321 on Fox Sports West. All right. We're 5:30. Weekdays.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's on the net, so you can find it anywhere around the country.
And also on the best damn sports show, period, which is moving right along. I mean, I remember when it came out and it had a name that was... controversial in the sense that people were like, that's not the best damn sports show. And
it's part of the
everybody,
part of the trick.
Everybody had their, the show had its detractors. But, it's been, 3 years now?
Yeah, it's going on its third.
And hasn't shown any signs of slowing down. All right, where were we?
You want to do something special on your wedding night. Have you ever licked his butt?
That would be Tom Arnold, by the way. Let's
maybe we should play
classy.
What?
The woman who we were asking about the Holocaust.
No.
Why?
No.
It was funny.
Yeah, right. we didn't have that.
How old was she?
Bring.
There it is.
Bring.
We have to set it up.
Hi, how you doing?
Set it up, though.
Give me a little preface here.
What ended up happening is we had a stripper call the show. I think she was a stripper.
Phone sex.
Phone sex operator. Okay. Sorry.
And the guys were getting off too fast.
And I said, she said,
she couldn't make any money.
How can I prolong this? Yeah, she made her money off minutes
by the minute,
logged on the phone. And if the guy would shoot his wad in the first 45 seconds, she's not going to make much money. So I said, well, maybe you're too hot. Maybe you're too sexy, And these women, they do this. They describe themselves as, 6'1", and they're Swedish, and they're, got a nice big D-rack on them. They're, narrow at the hip. They're big in the bust, and they're totally, And the guy's like, and then they don't make any money. So I said, what you ought to do? You ought to subliminally bring up negative things that would kill the boner. So in other words, you bring up the Holocaust, but don't start talking about it with him. Just slide it in between the sex talk.
And she's like,
and just sneak it in. Yeah, it'll that will kill his boner, and he won't even know why it's taking him longer. But you can just sneak it in.
It was a little quiet there in the line. Adam goes, "Do you know what the Holocaust is?" No.
She didn't know what that
Never
was.
Never. Because you heard of Stalin? No.
She wasn't
Hitler. Yeah, Hitler. Yeah.
She wasn't familiar with the subliminal. Either.
The subliminal, was a term that she couldn't.
Right. Remember. So what I wanted to say is what I wanted to do is her to go hey baby, what are you wearing? AIDS. Oh man, I am so brain cancer. Hi. just to sneak it in there. The
subliminal
guy,
man. Subliminal.
Subliminal man.
Subliminal phone sex
guy,
operator.
Guy probably have a few beers in him.
Ooh.
He doesn't know why it's taking so long.
Right.
But anyway, I said, look, you got to work in the Holocaust, and you have to do it fast. And okay, well, I think that's about enough.
So here's what happened.
Here's how she did it. Bring. Oh, Tom Arnold here that night.
Hi, how you doing? Ooh,
hi, what's your name?
I'm Sugar.
Sugar,
who are you?
I'm Ace.
Hey, Ace.
Yeah, what are you wearing?
Ooh, well, I'm wearing a nice black garter.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, just thinking about the Holocaust right now.
The best is Tom Arnold and us all just laughing our asses off. Play Tom Arnold laughing. I think we're going nuts.
Wait a minute. It's at the end.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi. What's your name?
Yeah,
he's got to fast forward to the end. I'm Ace. Yeah, but don't cut it off, because it really cracks me up hearing him crank up.
Well, I'm wearing a nice black garter. Ooh. I'm just thinking about the Holocaust right now.
Had a long build-up. That's why everyone went nuts. Oh. Where's the rest of it, Anders?
You got cut off.
Dude, I have it, at least. I don't have the whole show.
Tom laughed like 5 minutes after.
Oh, you don't have Tom Arnold like laughing like a madman. It just cranked
like,
me up.
Ooh, I'm thinking about the Holocaust right now.
It's like anti-Semite Mae West.
Ooh. Thinking about killing some
Jews. Yeah, killing some Jews. Why don't you come over to my oven and see me, big boy? Just come over to my oven and see me, big nose. Sarah? Drew, that was horrible.
Yes.
You're 20?
Yes, I am.
What's up?
Okay, I am a little history. I'm an ex-crackhead. I was doing it for 4 years. I quit about a year and 8 months ago. Yay for me.
Mm-hmm.
Good for you.
And I'm having a lot of problems now with sleeping. I sleep fine, but I find if I'm not doing things during the day, I just want to sleep. If I'm not out and around, I want to sleep. And I'm having a lot of trouble breathing. I lose my breath a lot during the day.
You quit how long ago?
A year and 8 months.
Yay for you.
And are you taking anything else now?
No, well, also when I eat, I get so full and I feel sick. Like, I feel like I want to throw up, but
Have you had a medical evaluation?
No.
So it could be anything. I mean, we're just, you know, it's hard to even speculate what's going on here. Do you smoke cigarettes?
I quit about 3 months ago.
Do you use any other drugs?
No.
Yay for you.
I drink. Yay.
And no prescription drugs?
No. I leave when I have a headache.
All right. So, Sarah.
Yes.
You know, the shortness of breath thing is a little freaky for a 20-year-old.
Oh, she was smoking cigarettes, too.
Yeah, but
not for a 20-year-old.
Yeah, she shouldn't be short of breath.
Unless there's some sort of panic attack or something that's going on.
Yeah.
But wanting to go to bed when you're not... Anytime you don't have something in front of you, it's sort of depression, usually.
And people that do a lot of speed do end up injuring their brain. Do you have any memory problems?
Oh, my God.
All right. The memory problems and the mood disturbance go together. And that is a reflection of brain injury. So you may well need to be on an antidepressant to try to elevate those chemicals that are so severely depleted now. But that still doesn't explain everything that's going on with you. You need a thorough medical evaluation. You need a lung exam. You need a chest x-ray. You need a cardiac evaluation. You got to figure out what's going on here. I mean, it could be anything what's happening.
Like sleep apnea?
No.
I mean, this could be anything from AIDS to cancer. Okay?
Okay.
Sleep apnea, interestingly, is not one of the things I'm thinking of.
All right. So, anyway, go get a workup. Go to the doctor. But good for you for quitting the speed, all right?
When you're doing crack for 4 years, I mean, does that...
Oh, the crack. Yes.
Well, crack or crank, did she say?
Oh, I thought she said crack.
I thought she said crack.
I thought she said she was a crackhead.
What was it?
Crank.
Crank.
Crankhead.
Oh, she said crankhead. And you normally don't hear crankhead.
No.
All right, good times,
but
baby doll.
She's not in recovery, though, interestingly.
Now, does crank, once it affects your brain, is it gone?
Mm.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, you know, you're not Muhammad Ali. You can take... There's medication you can take and stuff and restore some of them chemicals, right?
Not the memory problems. And the depressions tend to be very difficult to treat and long-term.
Nah.
Yeah.
That's not so bad.
Yeah.
You're fine.
Yeah.
Hey, maybe they'll score a 91, too.
Oh, I don't think they're going to get that low. Really, to be honest with you. All right, you ready to rock here, Drew?
There you go.
Let's talk to Sharon. Sharon?
Sharon.
Yeah, I was kind of looking at that, thinking that wasn't Sharon, but didn't have a
you
B.
You threw it out there.
I didn't have a B, B. You're 16. What's up?
Yeah, I want to know why when, like, I pee, I, like, pee in, like, two different directions.
Hmm.
Why that happens.
Like, bisexual.
Oh.
I don't know.
One into the wastebasket and the other...
Bidirectional. Into the magazine rack.
Magazine rack, yes.
That's what I do. That's why I don't take any chances. I pee in the sink now.
I know. Well, maybe now.
Or you can take a knee and get closer to the...
Ooh, look at that.
So grab a knee. Yeah, but why grab a knee when the sink's right there, you know? All you got to do is, you know, steer clear of the toothbrush, yeah. which I do 65%
of the time. You can sit down and do it like a girl.
Well, it's hard because you usually have an erection when I'm around the house.
Is there like a medical explanation for that?
Man, I was so impressed with that move.
You're
the erection and the sink. Just two things that just truly, truly impressive.
Impressive, classy.
How's the urethra doing? How's the opening of the...
I don't know. It seems like I have like... two openings.
No, you do not.
I mean, like, one big opening, the main urethra, and then a smaller vent, like, on a volcano, sort of.
The hell are you talking about?
Okay, yeah. But he's... Okay, either...
Somebody else put him up to this, and he thinks he's figured out why people get split stream, and he's trying to make it seem like he has that.
But he was...
Convincing himself that there's, like, two holes.
Right.
But he was using the volcano thing, which is, you know... The volcano sometimes will have an orifice that's open down the side of the hill a little bit, which we have talked about
there
as
is
it pertains to the penis.
There is such a thing, phimosis, yeah.
Doesn't sound like it's a Sharon's problem because he would know why he had a split stream if he had two openings.
That's
it's like calling up and saying, I can't get a steady stream out of my hose, but your dad backed over the nozzle and crimped.
Yeah.
Crimp the brass end on it. You wouldn't be calling a hardware store and asking, why is the water coming out funny? The thing's got a ding in it.
And the split stream is a sign of urethral irritation, and the urethra can get kind of sticky at the end, inflamed, and they'll send stuff all kinds of directions.
Also, you know, if you squeeze one out and then pass out and you don't urinate, there'll be a little blockage in there.
So if you ejaculate and then don't urinate.
Right.
Some guys get it right after ejaculation.
Yeah, well, the initial surge.
Doesn't it take a extra few seconds
to get it going? Yes, it can be a little tough.
Yeah, that's why in the sink.
Interesting.
In the sink, that's why Adam uses the sink.
Yeah, and that sink, that's not the work of a 91er. That's
no,
a triple digit.
That's a 160.
That's a triple digit idea right there.
Yeah.
Saving water. I care
about
that.
How about that energy that taking a knee or
having
squatting
to bend
down the
toilet, flush
the
toilet.
Even having to like bend down to pull up the toilet seat.
I mean, oh my God!
God forbid to bend over at the waist.
You just turn toward the sink.
Me whizzing out of my den window is not working out for me anymore. Though.
Why? You kill all plants?
I got a fern plant that's next to dead, and I realized when I got to my front door this evening that the smell when the wind's traveling the right way, it's starting to build up
that's
in
nice.
There.
Nice.
Poor Gardner.
It's very nice.
Jane?
Yeah, that's me.
You're 22?
Allegedly, yeah.
Allegedly, Jane, yes, all right.
What's up?
I've heard doing it like in a hot tub or a pool does damage to the girl. True, false?
Well, you're a little light on lubrication, but if it doesn't hurt, Leanne, what do you think?
Yeah, but I'm young.
You don't sound young.
Well, I am. I am.
You sound nuts.
Yeah, it's a little difficult to do it in water for women because you do lose lubrication.
Well, I mean it's like this. I already did it, so I've heard that it does damage, like endometriosis or whatever from, like, the chlorine getting up in your system. Is that?
Where did you hear about this?
It's a lot, man. Have you ever heard of that Canadian retard, Sue Johansson or whatever?
No.
No, but if she's a retard, I'd like to hang with her.
I'm not asking you, Adam. I'm asking Dr. Drew.
No, I'm not familiar with her. What has she done?
Okay, Jane.
Alleged Jane.
Be quiet. I don't know. She has like a show on... She's like a sex expert.
Oh, yes, that one. That old lady?
Yeah.
And she's called retard something?
No, if that were true.
That's what I call
her. Oh.
Because everything she says is the opposite of what Dr. Drew says, and I believe everything Dr. Drew says.
Thank you. She's not a medical doctor, and she makes comments... That she has really no business talking
about. Pulling out of the air.
That's what I thought.
No idea what she's talking about.
I
have never seen a problem with it. Talked to many people and seen patients that do the hot tub thing. Never seen a medical issue from that.
She said that, like...
Hey, Jane.
Yeah?
Listen to me for a second.
Yes, sir.
What's going on with you? You eat a lot of mushrooms?
No. I've never done drugs. Never even smoked pot.
Really?
Really.
Amen. Wow. Neither have I.
That's amazing.
That's great.
You're Squaresville, baby.
Never even smoked a cigarette,
We couldn't chill. We couldn't
hang. I don't drink.
I'm drinking, if that's what you sense.
Hey, so Jane, what do you do for work?
For work? Right now, I'm in college.
Okay. So, Jane, you're
right
one of
now.
No, she did that on purpose.
I know.
Jane, you're one of these tick through with this high IQ that kicks in like 10 seconds later. Jane, you're one of these smart people that is super weird, right?
Yeah.
And it's like it's going to be trouble because even though your brain functions very well, you're so weird, it never translates into a buck or a boyfriend or anything like that.
It's such a curse, isn't it?
Well, it is if you make it one.
Yeah.
So what do you got to stop being so weird.
Well, hey.
What are you going to do about that?
What are you going to do? That's why you make the big bucks. You tell me.
Yeah, you can stop acting weird. People don't have to know how insane you are.
I'm drinking right now. That's why I even bothered to call the show.
All right, baby doll.
All right.
Well, good times.
Well, no, seriously, okay.
And have fun in that hot tub.
Seriously, what?
No, okay, like, she said that because of the pressure or whatever, like, that the water gets, like, forced up into your, you know.
Yeah, it's an interesting idea, but of the millions of people that do this, never heard of one case.
It's funny that she answered her own question, and she's still asking me. She's I don't believe anything she said.
Because I don't believe her.
Yeah, but maybe there has been it reminds me of the business of somebody blowing into a woman's vagina and causing an air embolism and killing her.
I did that.
But there
once.
Is a case of that having had happened.
I did that. I was using a press there. I wasn't using my mouth.
For real, it happened. There's a way of accessing the venous system in some women under a certain amount of pressure and a certain, you know, angle and whatnot.
Yeah.
It apparently happened once.
I've done it. But you know what? It's still worth it. I'm that good. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Joe. 91. You got to be good. You got to be good at oral when you're toting around that 91 burden. Do you know what I'm saying?
I think you have to be good at oral, period.
You have to overcompensate. Yeah, but nice to be good at oral. But, you know, you got a 161, 162 IQ. You don't have to be great at oral. Obviously, there are other things you're good at. But you carry around that 91 windbreaker, you got to be good at oral. Mm-hmm. Thank God I am. Drew, tell Leanne how good I am at oral, even if I don't like it. That's the sound it's going to make.
You're good at receiving oral, I thought.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
No, yeah, yeah.
But you know, it is true, though, that intelligence is very sexy.
It is.
I said that about Drew last time.
It can be, but
still think so.
Watch how I receive oral. Watch how good I am at this. I'm sorry if there's some confusion if you thought I was talking about giving oral. I was talking about receiving. A lot of guys talk a good game about how good they are at giving oral. But not many guys can receive it properly.
Right.
Watch this. Just, you don't have to stay on your chair and stuff, but hypothetically, if you were performing oral on me, this is what it would look like. Watch this.
Wait, you're losing. Wait, concentrate.
All right.
Come on.
I can't focus.
Come on.
I can't focus.
I think we dim the lights.
Oh. There it goes. There he is. He's in the zone. Isn't that impressive?
Huh?
Man, I've never seen anybody receive it like you, Adam.
Yeah.
Impressive.
And like I said, any Tom, Dick, or Harry
can case study on this? Because I mean, that was
down on a woman. But how many people can properly receive oral? You know what I mean? No whacking on your head with a roofing hammer. No trying to shove a carpenter's awl into your eardrum. No squirting lighter fluid on the back of your blouse and lighting on fire. Just slow, subtle movements mixed in with a sprinkling of groans. Watch one more time. Hold on a second. Let me focus.
I get a little overwhelmed.
Take over the show. Let me focus.
I'm not sure I can see another
no, I'm gonna
rendition.
Do it.
It's tough. Know.
Sprinkling of groans.
I got to say that your concentration's been on. Look at you guys. Concentrate, dude. Come on.
Yeah, okay.
All right, ready?
Yeah, here we go.
And go. There we go.
Oh, yeah. I know what the ladies like. Yeah. They like giving me oral. Yeah. Not bad, huh? See if any
it was
of the,
that little twitch and the oh yeah at
yeah.
the same time.
See if the troops over there in your beloved Iraq would hold still for oral like me. I don't think so. Leanne Tweeden is here tonight. She is one of the number one chicks at watching me simulating receiving oral.
She did a good job.
She did a great job.
Excellent.
I was very captivated. I was a captivated audience.
It's a feather in your cap, baby doll. Take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, it's Loveline. That's a song that's playing when I stroll into the trendy club. Mr. 91, they call me. Walking in slow motion, wearing my shades.
I have to hold it down.
Jacket slung over my shoulder. Ladies checking me out. Buzzing. Word on the street is he's double digits. high double digits, ladies. Yeah. What is this?
This is how it... Leanne isn't paying attention. She doesn't understand. This is how you're actually viewed by the public.
This is what they hear?
Yeah.
How dare you. You people will never know the real me. You look at me as the clod that makes jack-off jokes on the radio. But you don't know that behind that clod, there's a clod that makes jack-off jokes at home. And not on the radio.
And has a 91 IQ.
And has a 91 IQ. Chantel?
Hi.
You're 17?
Yep.
What's up?
Okay, I have a boyfriend that's a little bit older than me. He's 22. Well, he'll be 22 tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And he gets kind of controlling and mad, and I don't really know what to do about him.
Mm-hmm.
Controlling in what way?
Like, I can't go certain places with certain people that he doesn't like or doesn't know. Or
how old is he?
22.
Mm-hmm.
Sort of a 19, 20-year-old guy's... MO.
Yeah.
Their thing.
Has he ever done anything violent?
No, he just yells. And then, like, one time we were on the phone talking, and he, like, threw his phone across the room.
Yeah, that's punching walls and throwing phones.
He has, like, hissy fits, like, tantrums, and I...
Yeah. But here's a question. Is there any merit for this? Did you ever get caught cheating?
No.
You don't have
He's been cheated on before.
He's been cheated on before.
He has.
Does he cheat? Has he cheated?
No.
And when you go out with people, it's your girlfriend's, not like your ex-boyfriend.
Oh, no. Like, I hate my ex-boyfriends, but...
Okay. Well, here's the thing. I do believe this, but Leanne can weigh in on this. I've been trying to tell Drew to use this on his wife since I've known him, but he won't do it, which is I do have this theory that people, when they can start to spin out a little, they get... they get accusatory and they get jealous, and when you backpedal, it gives them more momentum. They start spinning out a little more. Like, you start apologizing for things you didn't do, and the next thing you know, they feel empowered and then more out of control. Like, maybe you're doing something, you're apologizing. I think sometimes people want you to go, listen, stop it. I went out with my friend. We had a soda and we came home. That's it.
If you
relax.
Don't believe me, that's your problem.
Yeah. Now you got a problem over here, but it's not my problem.
Right.
If I was cheating, I wouldn't be in this relationship because that's not the way I work, and you know it, and I know it. I think people want you to sort of snap their underpants a little bit, wake them up, and sort of just—it's like tug on the chain a little.
Kind of the Chris slap on the face.
Well, but it's also containing their out of control feelings.
Yeah,
containing it for them.
But as a guy who remembers what it was like to be 19 and go through a girl's yearbook and go, who is this dude you went to the prom with 2.5 years ago? You know, I would have appreciated if she said, "Hey, listen, that guy. I don't know where that guy is. Who cares? It's about you and me now, and get over it."
What do you think about jealousy?
Me?
No, Dr.
It can mean lots of different things in lots of different situations.
Right.
I young males are prone to feeling threatened really easily.
Sure.
The testosterone does that to
them. Now, whether you think that's just from the testosterone or from justified,
I think more often than not, it is a biological thing that pushes them in that direction.
Sure.
Also, young males are very insecure. They don't feel worth somebody being committed to them. So the assumption is they're going to leave.
Yeah.
Right. So if you're going to leave, he's always going to have this anger towards you, and you're going to be cheating on him.
Then if individuals had abandonment experiences, then they sort of get that way and attempt to allegedly avoid it, but end up precipitating the same problem, making somebody
like you said, they just
them.
Keep spinning out of control.
Guys at 19 just do everything that is wrong when it comes to relationships. So I do think women need to tell the guy in no uncertain terms that this isn't happening. It's their problem. They got to get over it. If they don't listen to that a couple of times, feel free to move on.
When you're young, honey, move on.
Mm-hmm.
Find somebody that'll be nice to you.
Don't get into that game that, no, baby, I was with Sheila and we were at a movie. I'll show you the ticket stub. You start getting into that, and then it's like as if you did do something. Yeah, don't dance with them. This isn't, you've not been hauled into court for anything. There's no body. There's no victim.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Amanda?
Yeah.
You're 16?
Yep.
What's up?
I refuse, I cannot get oral, I don't get off of oral, and I don't get off of giving oral, and I just...
Mm. Yeah, you would get off of giving oral if you saw the way I receive it. That is a turn-on.
Yeah, you've got to see it, trust me.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
Sometimes I take my pants all the way off.
Oh, instead of just to the ankles?
Well, I'm just the zipper, just using the fly.
Oh, God.
Okay. Why?
She likes that. That's good.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes there's a mess. I'll take my pants
that
down to my
and
knees.
The sink.
Yeah.
I'm just overwhelmed tonight.
Hot. All right. So, Amanda.
Yeah.
That's fine. You're 16.
Yeah. Relax, Amanda. That's fine.
That's how it works.
Like, my boyfriend and, like, I don't want to, like, disappoint him or anything.
Mm. And, like, what?
And, like, yeah.
All right. Well, do you... You don't want to disappoint him because you don't want to give him oral sex?
Because I've done it before, and, like, the first time I did it was, like, a really bad experience.
Mm. Yeah. Well, that's the way it is with most things in life, like work and school and most sports, you know. I mean, you do get better at things. You do learn to enjoy things.
Sure.
Yeah, look at me. I didn't like booze when I was 14. Can you imagine?
Like, I won't even try it with another guy.
What happened the first time?
What was so traumatic?
I, like, almost choked and, like, the guy was, like, holding my head and I couldn't breathe.
Oh, boy.
And I
all right.
Punch him.
Yeah, see, that's not my technique. I don't hold the head. I wrap a towel around the head and pull down, and then I sit on the towel ends, you know, keeps him down there.
Nice. Yeah.
But I don't hold the head. Amanda?
Yeah.
Okay, so you had a bad experience.
Just to give it some time. How old were you then?
I was 15.
Wow.
14.
All right. Of course
all right.
You have
we take it slow, but listen, earth the tards out there. You can get behind the wheel of a car and get in an accident backing out of the driveway the first time you ever get behind the wheel of a car. It doesn't mean that's going to happen every mile you travel. And I know it's difficult because people's minds are feeble.
Well, their brains are still wet. They haven't evolved. They haven't cemented yet. And this is their first exposure. And
no, listen, I know.
But also, the guys that are doing it, if he wants to have it done again, you would think he wouldn't do that.
I just think as a society, we're too understanding about this. We're like, oh. Mm. No, people have to say, look, of course this was a bad experience for you.
Fall off the bike a couple times, get back on.
Yeah, it happens now and again. But if you're with a guy you like, come on, do the math.
Or she gets a little older and she finds somebody that she knows it's the right person to try it with again.
Right.
That she's not going to be worried that he's going to choke her and whatever.
Right.
You know what I mean?
She's 16. Just relax. If you're with a guy you love, fine. Leanne tweeting here. I'm going to take another IQ test during the break. I'll take the same test.
Oh, yes.
And I'm going to answer them all as fast as I can. I'm just going to check boxes.
Random.
I'm going to read them. Let's see what happens after this. Turn, Kitty. Big A, 115 in the IQ department.
Mm-hmm.
Went up a solid 24 points just in the over the commercial break.
Just using your instincts only.
Adam, too many falses.
I just randomly took the test. Actually, I had to have Drew do it because I couldn't work the mouse very well.
Mouse problems.
I want to thank Leanne Tweeden for coming in here tonight.
It's
always
time again.
Always a breath of fresh air in here. 54321 on Fox Sports Net. And always great to see you, Leanne.
Thank you.
Come back anytime.
Thanks for having me.
Our
I was
pleasure.
Happy to come back.
All right. So, until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
I'm drinking right now. That's why I even bothered to call the show.
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Ingold. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.